Welcome back to the channel. In this new series of video, I'm going to solve the labs regarding race condition topic published by PortSwigger on Web Security Academy. This topic was also presented on Black Hat USA 2023. Let's read the description. Race conditions are a common type of vulnerability closely related to business logic flows. They occur when websites process the request concurrently without adequate safeguards. This can lead to multiple distinct threads interacting with the same data at the same time, resulting in a collision that causes unintended behavior in the application. A race condition attack uses carefully timed requests to cause intentional collision and exploit this unintended behavior for malicious purpose. This image here describes a little bit how it works. It has like a time range in which you can apply like multiple requests, and these multiple requests can create a collision. In this example, we can see that there are multiple gift cards applied, which normally with a session with an account, you just have one gift card available. So the lab that we are going to solve will deal with this kind of vulnerability, which we will be able to submit more discount code and pay the item with a less price of the one initially intended. Now, to understand quickly what is the race condition in act in this lab, we can see that normally if you submit two requests in a time frame, in different time frame, you can see that the first request will be evaluated with a discount code and you will receive a response true. However, in the second request, you can see that if we submit a discount code, we will receive the false response, which indicates that the discount code is as an invalid code or it has been already applied. So the risk condition that we are going to trigger is this one, which in the time frame of 5 milliseconds we will submit two requests and both of these two requests will be evaluated as true in the discount code, and we will be able to leverage the vulnerability race condition. There are many variations of kind of attack, including redeeming a gift card multiple times, raiding a product multiple times, withdrawing or transferring cash in excess of your account balance, reusing a single captcha solution, bypassing an anti-brute force race limit. Some of these will be covered in the labs that I will going to solve. Now let's shift more in a technical way. We can see in this diagram that if we have two requests, we can send them through the internet layer connection, but normally there are different factors that we need to take in consideration, which are a network latency, jitter, internal latency, and the race window that we want to hit with both of the requests. Thanks to this new version of Burp, the 2023.9, it has in the Burp repeater tab a new functionality which can you group different requests and send them in a parallel way. This, as you can see, reduce the impact of one of these factors, namely network jitter. And this works in both of the protocol, HTTP version 1 and HTTP version 2. The version 1, it uses the classic last byte synchronization technique, and the HTTP 2, it uses the single packet attack technique, first demonstrated by PortSwigger research at Black Hat USA 2023. To be more detailed, the single packet attack enables you to completely neutralize the interference from network jitter by using a single TPC packet to complete 20 or 30 requests simultaneously. Now let's focus on the lab. Let's read the description. This lab's purchasing flow contains a race condition that enables you to purchase items for an intended price. To solve the lab, successfully purchase a lightweight L33T leather jacket. You can log in to your account with the following credential, Miner Peter. So let's proceed. As you can see, here we have the promo code, which is promo20. Let's log in. As you can see, our current balance is $50. So let's try to purchase the leather jacket, which has a higher cost than our current balance, so we need to find a way to submit multiple discount code. But as you can see, on the second trial, the discount code will not be taken. So let's find a way on how to submit multiple discount code in order to have a price lower than
our current balance. And
in this way, we are going to solve the lab. So now let's move to Burp. And as you can see here, if we take a look on the proxy, we have all the traffic that we are currently using. And the requests that interest us are this one and get cart. One thing is that all the discount code and all the items that we want to purchase are linked to our current session. So as you can see, if I remove the cookie, the cart will be empty. And on the other side, the discount code can be applied just one. So let's try to create multiple requests and save them into a tab. We can use Ctrl plus R to speed up the process. Okay, now we can create a group tab. Let's call it race condition. And we will add all the requests that we need. I think the we need 20 requests, so let's send it here in this tab. And as you can see now, all the requests are in this tab. Let's move to the interface and let's remove the promo code. And if we move back to Burp, we can see that there are different ways to submit multiple requests. The first one can be useful to assume what kind of handling there is in the backend system. And as you can see, in this way, we will send single connection, multiple packet.
It's just the first request will be applied, and the second, the third,
and so on will be rejected. So this is not the right way to submit a race condition. We need to use send group in parallel, single packet attack. So let's remove the discount code from our cart. And if we move back here and we send the parallel request, we can see that this, but also the others, will be evaluated as true. So if we shift back to the cart, now we can see that the price is lower. I'll show you. And if we place the order, we will solve the lab. Thanks for the attention. See you in the next video.